Please give a cool and cynical Independent Spirit Awards welcome to your host for today's show, the star of Sarah Silverman, Jesus is Magic, Sarah Silverman.
Good afternoon. God, it's so exciting to be here hosting the Independent Spirit Awards. Last year, Samuel Jackson hosted them, and he was so great. I think this year they wanted to go whiter, is the thing, but he definitely did want to be here today, but I think his Kangol hat was at the cleaners or something. So what's the difference between the Independent Spirit Awards and the Oscars? Well, first of all, the Oscars are chosen by the Academy of Motion Pictures, Arts and Sciences. These are chosen by Judah Friedlander. The Academy Awards honors the biggest directors and superstar actors, while this show is the champion of struggling artists, like Ang Lee and George Clooney. Also, this year, the Oscars are being hosted by a Jew, where this show is being hosted... Hey! We really do run Hollywood. Holly weird, I call it. Just think of the Academy Awards as one of those like fancy schmancy gourmet supermarkets, and the Independent Spirit Awards as like the 99 cent store. And that is not an insult, that's a compliment. Okay, I buy everything at the 99 cent store because I don't like giving extra money to the man for a label or a brand name. It's the same product. You know what I mean? I mean, the only thing I would buy maybe brand name is the feminine washes. Douches? I don't even know like the formal name. Like Vagrants? Vagrances. They have them at the 99 cent store. It's called Fresh Love. But I know it's totally me, but I just can't. And can we just sidebar for a second? And let me just say that I'm musing about this for the joke, but I totally don't need that in life. I'm serious. I would love to be like a self-deprecating comedian, but there isn't anything. You know what I mean? George Clooney, listen to this. I swear to God, may Jesus make me die a painful, slow death if I'm lying. My vagina smells like a mountain breeze. It smells exactly like a mountain breeze. Oh, so back to the joke, I would probably buy brand name. I would probably buy Massengill or whatever. And it's totally my hang-up, but I just have a problem putting anything inside me that is costs less than $8. But let's talk about the real reason we're here besides my vagina. First of all, congratulations to everyone involved in the groundbreaking movie, Brokeback Mountain. Sure. That's enough. Don't spoil them. The first gay Western since Urban Cowboy. I actually went to see Brokeback Mountain with my boyfriend, and it was so beautiful. He actually closed his eyes during the gay sex scenes. He's not homophobic at all. It's just it's the only way he can come. Hi, friend. So Jewish. Crash is nominated for Best First Feature. It is... Sure. That's enough. It is a thought-provoking drama for socially aware Americans, or a hilarious comedy for racist Americans. It covers all the bases. It's for everybody. actually. I wrote that joke at the Glendale Galleria, and I'd like to give it a shout out if I may. I love the Galleria, because they're like, let's call it something that makes you think of art, yet also reminiscent of diarrhea. How about the Galleria? I love it. Done and done. Too often award shows put the emphasis on the director, the producer, the whatever the guy that holds the camera is called. But what about the unsung heroes? The actors. There are a lot of them here tonight. George Clooney is here, from Facts of Life all the way to Good Night and Good Luck. You have proven yourself in worlds both artsy and fartsy. And I commend ye. I saw Amy Adams, and Amy, I did not see Junebug, but I have been telling everybody that I think your performance was amazing. Nuts! God, Philip Seymour Hoffman's here, Katherine Keener, Naomi Watts, Heath Ledger, the Olsen twins. Oh my God, Felicity Huffman. I am such a huge fan of his. Kevin Smith, my guitar. Let's take it down a second. Thanks, Dal. You know, I promised the producers I wouldn't bring up the Holocaust in the monologue. Keep it light, they said. But I'm very edgy. Very edgy. More about that later. First, I would like to bring up two people who have done more for African Americans in film than Sidney Poitier and myself combined. To present the award for Best Supporting Actress, please welcome Billy Baldwin and Sandra Oh.
This year's nominees for Best Supporting Female are an especially distinguished group of actresses, known for their deep commitment to independent film.
These women prove that in independent film, it's not the size of the role that counts, it's the size of the performance that counts. The nominees are Amy Adams, Junebug.
Are you wearing makeup? Because you could wear more if you wanted to. You're so tall, I'm fair. But I like to experiment with a lot of different looks. Were you born in Chicago? I was born right here, lived here my whole life. My favorite animal is the meerkat. Do you know what they are? They're so cute. Oh, I've got this little charm bracelet with meerkats on it. Do you have lots of boyfriends? I bet you did. Did you ever try out for cheerleading or anything? I tried out, but I didn't make it.
I was born in Japan.
You were not.
Maggie Gyllenhaal, Happy Endings.
Son, very well, do you?
Well, I don't think you should leave. I insist you stay. I'm gonna talk to Otis, because there's no way to treat somebody you care about.
God. I wish he was more like you.
Well, he's young, and maybe I could have done a better job. But I was a kid when I had him, practically.
Do you know what? You remind me of the first boy I dated.
Hardly a boy.
Now you're lying.
Allison Janney, our very own.
Billy has written me a number of rubbery checks lately, if you know what I mean.
Well, why haven't you let me know?
Well, I was hoping to handle this with Mr. Whitfield, but he hasn't taken care of it as of yet.
All right,
How much do we owe you?
It's quite a bit, Joan.
Michelle Williams, Brokeback Mountain.
I said hello, and this brings you fresh my red armor. And then you come back looking all perky. I said you caught a bunch of browns and you ate them up. Do you remember? I looked in that case first chance I got, and there was my note still tied there. That line hadn't touched water in its life.
It mean nothing, Elmer.
Don't try and fool me no more, Ennis. I know what it means. Jack Twist. Jack Nasty.
Robin Wright Penn, 9 lives.
There's just always been this fucking thing that swallows me. I gotta go. You can't just come up to me. After 100 years, married, and tell me that you think about me. You can't do that.
And the Spirit Award goes to Amy Adams for Junebug. Thank you so much, Film Independent, and this is overwhelming. This means so much to me. Our film was such a true independent, and the cast, most of whom are here today, M. Beth and Celia and Scott and Ben and Alessandro and Frank and everybody in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, our interns who worked for next to nothing, and our crew that worked for next to nothing, and all of our extras who just showed up and were so eager. It was just such a spirit on this film, and it's just so nice that people are seeing it, and that it just means so much to me. Thanks to my entire team, who's always supported my independent spirit, which I'm sure can be a handful, and really just thank you, everybody. Michael Barker and Tom Bernard for carrying on independent film the way you do. Thank you. Thank you, all of you. I appreciate it.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Barrymores of independent film. From Broken Flowers, Julie Delpy, and from Find Me Guilty, Vin Diesel.
Bonjour.
Bonjour.
Okay, the award given to new talent every year are at the very heart of the mission of Film Independent and the Spirit Awards.
The first of these is the award for best screenplay. Past winners include the first produced scripts of Charlie Kaufman, Neil LaBute, Darren Aronofsky, and David O. Russell. This year's nominees are for Fixing Frank, Kenneth Haynes.
For Me, You, and Everyone We Know, Miranda July.
For Junebug, Angus McLaughlin.
For The Beautiful Country, Sabina Murray.
And for Transamerica, Duncan Tucker.
And the Spirit Awards, it's like an envelope with like, no, yeah, okay, I get it, all right. Duncan Tucker for Transamerica.
Wow, I didn't expect to be up here. Thank you. And thank you, you know, the other screenwriters, Miranda, Angus, Sabina, Kenneth, for your beautiful work. Thank you so much, you know. Just a little over a year ago, like a year and a week ago, we premiered at Berlin, and a year and 2 months ago, I was just hoping like hell we'd get into a festival somewhere. And my great producers, Sebastian Dungan, Linda Moran, Renee Bastian, when we got the like $3 together to make this movie, they said, okay, we can squeeze it out, but anybody you've ever heard of, you can't afford. And it was the only thing they were ever wrong about. We were able, right down the line, people responded to this screenplay. I was so touched behind the scenes and in front of the scenes, and I want to thank my beautiful cast. Spanula Flanagan is here, Elizabeth Pena is here, Kevin Zegers is here, and the glorious Felicity Huffman's here. I love you guys. Thank you.
He's nominated today for Hustle and Flow, and she's the star of the upcoming Factory Girl. Please welcome Terrence Howard and Sienna Miller.
We're trying to get back to the gift lounge. Well, honestly, quite often, likable performers are called upon to play unlikable characters who don't always do the right thing, right?
Well, nobody can accuse the following talented actors of seeking out roles that make them look good.
So the nominees for Best Supporting Male are Firdaus Bamji, The War Within.
I haven't forgotten my identity. I'm not saying things are perfect here, okay? I know they're not perfect. I walk into an airport, I get into an airplane, I see the way people look at me. Look around you, Yad. Look in this restaurant. There are Jews, Christians, Muslims, everyone sitting here eating comfortably, safely, peacefully. Going to school together, businesses together. What's wrong with that?
Matt Dillon, Crash.
You know what I can't do? I can't look at you without thinking about the 5 or 6 more qualified white men who didn't get your job.
It's time for you to go.
Now, I'm saying this because I'm really hoping that I'm wrong about you. I'm hoping that someone like yourself, someone who may have been given a helping hand, might have a little compassion for someone in a similar situation.
Carol, I need security in my office.
You know, you don't like me. That's fine. I'm a prick. My father doesn't deserve to suffer like this.
Jesse Eisenberg, The Squid and the Well.
Everything's so serious suddenly. We're not getting married.
What are you saying?
Nothing. I just don't want to feel this pressure from you.
Do you like someone else? Your dad's girlfriend?
No. No, why? No, and she's not his girlfriend.
My father said you had a weak handshake, which is a sign of indecision.
His hands are so huge, I can't get a good grip.
My mother said you don't have a very good model for relationships because of your parents.
What? Your mother doesn't know anything. Well, I thought it went well. You told me she said I was hilarious.
Barry Pepper, The Three Burials of Melquiades Estrada.
That hurt me. I regret it every single day. Forgive me. Forgive me. Melquiades. For taking your life, forgive me.
And Jeffrey Wright, Broken Flowers.
You took it. Just conservative. A little classy. Don't give anything away. And always, always bring flowers. Pink flowers. And look for clues about your son. photographs, anything, or hints like pink stationery and red ink, handwriting if possible, and find that typewriter. Bring me that typewriter, and then I can forensically match the type to the letter.
You're insane, Winston.
And the Spirit Award goes to
Matt Dillon, Crash.
Thank everybody who voted for me for this. And I want to say that the cop that Barry Pepper played in that film was a bigger asshole than the cop that I played. But it's a great performance. It's a great performance. And, you know, when I was thinking about what I'd want to talk about here tonight, the thing I wanted to talk about was perseverance. And you know, for me, that's... I think anybody who's creative understands what that's all about, any actor, anybody who's been creative. And certainly, you know, passion has been the thing that's helped me to persevere. And when I saw the passion that Paul Haggis brought to the film Crash, I knew that he was onto something, and I'm really honored to be a part of it. The cast was awesome, and I share this with them. What else? I want to thank the producers. I want to thank everybody at Lionsgate. I want to thank Kathy Schulman. I want to thank a lot of people, but they're not all coming to me right now. But I want to thank my reps, Vic Ramos, Lee Stolman, and just everybody. This is really awesome. I'm very excited about this. Thank you very much.
By the way, is Duncan Tucker a funny name for a guy who wrote a movie about transsexuals? Anyway, Transamerica features a man that is a woman. Brokeback Mountain brings us cowboys that are gay. Screenplays this year are filled with rich, contrasting, almost paradoxical characters. For instance, in Hustle and Flow, Terrence Howard plays a black pimp who raps. Here to present the award for Best Screenplay, Virginia Madsen from Prairie Home Companion, and from Thank You for Smoking, Aaron Eckhart.
You probably know one or two of the unforgettable lines from independent films over the years, like Samuel Jackson talking about French cheeseburgers in Pulp Fiction, or Paul Giamatti complaining about fucking Merlot in Sideways.
Wow.
Hey, you know what I mean? It's the Independent Spirit Awards.
Oh, I'm up. Do you know that these lines were actually written by actual screenwriters?
Really?
Yeah, that's right. Because...
It wasn't all improv.
No, we don't have the time to come up with our own dialogue.
That's true.
We have so many other things to do.
We're actors. We're not supposed to do that.
That was my line.
So that's why we're so grateful.
We're good. We rehearsed.
To today's nominees for Best Screenplay. This was a bad idea to bring out the popcorn, man. The fact that you were there working on a beautiful script made each one of these movies so much easier to make.
Yeah, the nominees are The War Within by Ayad Akhtar, Joseph Costello, and Tom Glynn.
The Three Burials of Melquiades Estrada, Guillermo Arriaga.
The sound, the squid and the whale. What? Give me a break.
The prompter is by really
Noah
far
Baumbach.
Away.
And the guy's pointing at it. You're doing a good job.
It's a woman pointing at it. See. Capote, Dan Futterman.
And Nine Lives by Rodrigo Garcia.
And the Spirit Award goes to Dan Futterman for Capote.
Thank you. I think there are two people who I really need to thank, and that's Larry McMurtry and Diana Ossana for having the grace to not be nominated today. So thank you very much. I got to make this movie with people who I love. I met two of the most talented people I know when I was a teenager, Bennett Miller and Philip Seymour Hoffman. And 25 years later, we got to make this movie together. And we got to do it with our friend Caroline Barron, who is a fiercely protective and devoted producer. And with Infinity Media, our friends who are brave enough to jump onto this project with United Artists, the sadly defunct United Artists. Michael and Tom at Sony Classics have been amazing in getting this movie out here. And my agents at the Gersh Agency for finding two seats for my mom and dad, who are right over there. Sorry, I'll leave in 1 second. I just want to also say my wife, Anya Epstein, is here. Without her, I never would have figured out how to do this. So I love you. Thank you very much for this.
Ladies and gentlemen, and others, please give an encouraging round of applause to the first of today's singing presenters to perform Brokeback Mountain. Here is Peter Gallagher.
Congratulations. I'm sure there may be one or two of you who remember that ever since someone put LSD in the ice water at the very first Independent Spirit Awards in 1968, we've honored the best nominees by singing a ridiculous song about them. And today, almost 40 years later, although it seems, geez, barely half of us are tripping. And I'm pretty sure it's this half. So you guys got to drink your ice water. It's a lot more fun than that. We're going to stick to tradition and do it again. Excuse me. So here's the first of today's best feature songs. Maestro, Something Ridiculous, if you please.
On top of a broke back, all covered with sheen, two amorous cowboys aren't getting much sleep. I wish I could quit you, says one to the next, though then I'd be lonely and quite undersexed. Both cowboys have children, both cowboys have wives, which means that both cowboys have frustrating lives. One consolation to even the scores, when you're a gay cowboy,
your closet's outdoor.
Thank you.
Here is Brokeback Mountain.
You know, it could be like this, just like this, always.
If you can't fix it, you gotta stand it.
It's nobody's business but ours.
She played Woman on the Bus in Angie and Female Bartender in Dark Places. Back by popular demand, the executive director of Film Independent, Dawn Hudson.
Hello, everyone. Okay, what about all those Spirit Award nominees who are also nominated for Oscars? This is a question I get asked 100 times every day. Well, what about the 75% of the films nominated here today who aren't nominated by the Academy? These films are every bit as important to us at Film Independent. We're thrilled to have... Thank you. We're thrilled to have Ang Lee here with Brokeback Mountain, just as we were thrilled to have him at the Spirit Awards in 1994 with The Wedding Banquet. And we are thrilled that David Strathairn is here today for Good Night and Good Luck, just like we were thrilled to have him in 1988 for Matewan and four other times since. The importance of it, yes. He's been good every time. The importance of the Spirit Awards and of Film Independent is that we shine a spotlight on new talent to help filmmakers further their careers, just as we welcome established filmmakers. We're all together under a big tent, literally and figuratively. So whether you're here today or watching us on television around the world, you're all part of the Film Independent community. Now, Film Independent is the organization that throws this big party once a year, and we spend the rest of our time providing access for people who have a story to tell. Access to workshops and labs and equipment. Access for young filmmakers who are part of our diversity program, Project Involve. And access to the most important commodity in the information age, which is, of course, information. Information that will help you make and sell your film. Now, maybe providing access doesn't sound so sexy, but it's the very heart of what we do. And it's the story behind the smaller films and newer artists who you'll see here today and here only. By providing access in a million different ways and protecting artists, whether or not they have commercial success, we are building a community, which in turn has started a revolution. A revolution in technology, in film distribution, and a revolution that means you don't need anyone's permission anymore to make your movie. And this revolution belongs to independent film. At Film Independent, we're also dedicated to giving filmmakers access to audiences and audiences access to films. That's why we present the Los Angeles Film Festival in the summer. This year, in our new home in Westwood Village, the festival will be bigger and better than ever before. And just because we're independent, that doesn't mean we're not polite, which means we thank our hosts. Not just the divine Sarah Silverman, who has brought feminine hygiene humor to the Spirit Awards at long last, but also our incredible sponsors, who are our partners as well. The principal sponsors of the 2006 Independent Spirit Awards are Dockers San Francisco, L'Oreal Paris, American Express, and Acura. And our premier Thank you all. And our premier sponsors are Pop Secret, Netflix, Entertainment Weekly, and IFC, which is broadcasting this show live, and AMC, where you can see it again tonight. We quite literally couldn't do it without you. And our gratitude for your support and your vision is boundless. Thank you.
I'm here with Peter Gallagher, who just went through a traumatizing experience. Peter, I heard they made your eyebrows go through security 3 times before they let you in. Is that true? How do you feel about that?
Well, I missed the salad.
Boring. Here to present the award for Best Foreign Film is an actress whose name sounds like the yummiest candy in the world, Zi Jiang, and an actor whose name sounds just like Josh Lucas.
Years ago, I got my first acting job, and I was a nervous mess, and the actor who I was working with who helped me through it was Dan Futterman. So I gotta say a huge congratulations to Dan Futterman. Foreign films are to independent movies what independent films are to the mainstream, a rich source of inspiration, of experimentation, of new talent, and of truthful storytelling.
Spanning continents, time zones, and styles, the films nominated for Best Foreign Film this year have absolutely nothing in common, except their quality and, of course, their uniqueness. The nominees are...
The Death of Mr. Lazarescu, director Christy Pui. Duck Season, director Fernando Mbeke. Head On, director Fatia King. Paradise Now, director Hani Abu Assad. Tony Takatani, director Jun Ichikawa.
And the Spirit Award goes to Paradise Now, director Hani Abu Assad.
Thank you very much. Thank you. I recognize that I own a lot of people. My thank from the deepest bottom of my heart. My co-writer and producer, Biro Bayer. My actors, Kaisan Ali and Amir. My Israeli co-producer, Amir Harel. Without him, we couldn't make this film. Thank you, Amir. My German producers, they are also here. Roman and Gerard, and the last, Warner Independent, Mark Gill, Paul Federbusch, Laura and Steven, thank you from the bottom of my heart, thank you.
It's time for the second of today's Best Feature Songs, Capote, and believe it or not, here to perform it are the fabulous Macy Gray and Plucking Trumans of the All Capote Band.
You're tiny and effeminate. Your voice is just a squeak. So people tend to write you off the moment that you speak. You're nobody's idea of a journalistic star. But that's the way you got. You charm charm the sheriff too. You even charm the murderers who put their trust in you. They never thought you'd take that trust and drag it through the mud. That's what it took to birth your book. You wrote it in cold blood. That's what it took to birth your book. You wrote it in cold blood.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is Capote.
Have you read the article about the killings in Kansas? I think that's what I want to write about.
It's as if Harry and I grew up in the same house. He stood up and went out the back door, while I went out the front.
Guilty. What is the sentence?
Death.
He says it's the nonfiction book of the decade.
We still haven't talked about that night. What's the name of your book? In Cold Blood. Isn't that good?
And now to present the Independent Spirit Award for Best Documentary, here is the host of the Henry Rollins Show, Henry Rollins, and the director of the documentary, Yo Soy Boricua, Rosie Perez.
The dynamic duo over here. Well, go ahead.
Documentary films are becoming more and more popular at the box office, proving that the most intriguing stories can't be made up by Hollywood.
And we are pleased to honor these five films that capture the drama of real life.
And the nominees for Best Documentary are?
Enron, The Smartest Guys in the Room, director Alex Gibney.
I would like to know if you are on crack.
Grizzly Man,
and the Longhorns,
director Werner Herzog.
And the drovers are gone. The Comanches.
I will die for these animals. I will die for these animals. I will die for these animals.
La Sierra, directors Scott Dalton, Margarita Martinez. Romantico, director Mark Becker. Sir, No Sir, director David Zeiger.
We're resigning from the military. Come and get us.
And the Spirit Award goes to... You want to read it?
Sure. Enron, The Smartest Guys in the Room, directed by Alex Gibney.
Wow, this is a bit of a surprise. I must say also, I'm a little bit surprised by the category. I mean, the executives at Enron were some of the greatest fiction writers of all time. So, this is a tremendous vindication. This was a great, it was a great human tragedy and a great economic injustice. This film took a lot of work and a lot of help. I want to thank Mark Cuban and Todd Wagner, my great producers, Susan Mutamid, Jason Cleott, Joanna Vicente, Peter Coyote, the wonderful narration he did, and Bethany McLean and Peter Elkind, on whose giant shoulders I stood, the great reporters who helped to uncover this story. So thank you very much, everybody, for this great honor. Thank you.
My family. Let's hear it for the Crystal Method. Aren't they amazing? That's enough. It doesn't get old. I'll be honest, and this is no offense to you because you guys are great, but you're not the best house band for a comedian, you know? Their idea of a rim shot is like a mashup of like a British siren and a woman screaming. That's not bad. How about this? George Clooney put on so much weight for Syriana, I threw my back out. That's the independent way. Here to present the award for Best First Feature, please welcome Matt Dillon.
You know, there's a point in most award shows where someone explains how the voting process works. But if we skip that and we get through this quickly, there's a chance that some of you can make it over to Barry Diller's place for lunch. So let's keep moving, shall we? The nominees for Best First Feature are Crash.
You think you know who you are? You have no idea.
In L.A.? Nobody touches you. We're always behind this metal and glass.
Put your hands on top of your head, man.
Will you just do what he says?
Your brother's file. Kid's going away for life for stealing a car.
Heads in plain sight, step out of the vehicle.
Oh! Honey, stay inside.
Man, don't walk up on me.
I know this man.
Get back.
I think we miss that touch so much that we crash into each other just so we can feel something.
My journey with Nanny began. Just like me, everyone had a story as to how they ended up at Nanny's. And the blues I heard and the stories they told will live inside of me forever.
Me, you, and everyone we know.
Did you want to try these on?
No.
So those are comfortable?
They kind of rub my ankles, but all shoes do that.
You think you deserve that pain, but you don't.
It's kind of like that point in a relationship, you know, where you suddenly realize it's not going to last forever.
Yeah, but we're not even there yet. We're still at the good part. We're not even sick of each other yet.
I'm not sick of you at all.
Thumbsucker.
Justin. Are you ready to let go of your thumb?
Why are you talking like that?
Classic hyperactive teen.
But it's not that simple.
Maybe it is. No, you should see it. And he wears this tie. We have to overcome the idea that everyone is the same.
You're a killer. You're a stone-faced killer.
It works. I changed.
You don't fool yourself into thinking you got the answer.
Yeah, I feel great.
Euphoric, even?
Aren't you just my orthodontist?
Transamerica.
The usual electrolysis, 3 years of hormone therapy, and a facial feminization surgery. I got a phone call last night. He claimed to be Stanley's son.
No third person.
My son.
When everything is broken, we can mend it if we try.
And the Independent Spirit Award goes to Crash, Paul Haggis.
Thank you. This is, well, frankly, it's a little humiliating. The best first feature part. I did want to thank all the other boys and girls who were nominated. It took me a little longer to get around to it, but we did, and I'm glad that we had such terrific people supporting us, believing in us when no one else did. And luckily, I don't have to name them because they're all on the stage here with me. And so I want to thank Deborah and Larry, Bexy, who were champions from the beginning. And I don't know, Bobby, say something. Bobby saves me always.
Yeah, no, Bobby's not ready to save him today. We want to thank everybody up here on the stage. That's what's really important about Haggis. Haggis woke up one morning and said to me, I got an idea for a story, and all of these people on stage came aboard. Mark Harris, Kathy Shulman, Bob Yari. Don Cheadle is not here. Every actor that's in the show, they did the tremendous effort that they put forth under really tough circumstances. We can't thank them enough. So thank all of you, and I want to thank my wife Barbara, my daughter Jess, David Gallad, Alan Rado, and everybody else.
Thank you.
You know, having won the best first feature again, it's really terrific, because it happened in Gods and Monsters in '98. So I want to thank everybody at the Independent Spirit Award, my wife Lisa, who's a great support, my granddaughters are always pushing me, and my kids, and everybody in the cast who are brilliant, and it's just a great honor. Thanks.
Here to sing a little song about a squid and a whale are Zoe Deschanel and from Winter Passing, Alejandro Nivola from Junebug.
I write books, but I'm stagnating, 'cause they're too dance to sell. She's on yours with no waiting. It's exasperating.
I better break up, 'cause I need a lie. Let it stand beyond your head. I better break up, I can't be wise.
And now, the squid and the whale.
Your mom and I are going separate.
What about the cat?
A cat. I want to be a tennis pro like Ivan.
Ivan is a Philistine.
What's a Philistine?
It's a guy who doesn't care about books or interesting films and things.
Then I'm a Philistine.
No, you're interested in books and things.
No, I'm a Philistine.
You never made a dinner.
I made burgers the time you had pneumonia.
Burgers.
And now from Factotum, here is Lily Taylor, and from American Dreams, Willem Dafoe.
Every year at the Independent Spirit Awards, Film Independent presents three grants to support the work of up-and-coming filmmakers, the not-so-young and old men and women whom we believe are the future of independent film.
Thanks to our generous sponsors, we are able to give this next generation of great filmmakers just enough money to buy some creative breathing room, but not so much so that they get spoiled and lazy. Film Independent has scientifically determined that the precise, correct amount to give our winners is $25,000.
The first first of the Grant Awards, the Truer Than Fiction Award, is given to an emerging director of nonfiction features. This year's the finalists are...
Rachel Boynton, director of Our Brand is Crisis. Garrett Scott, Ian Olds, directors of Occupation Dreamland. Mark Becker, director of Romantico. Thomas Allen Harris, director of 12 Disciples of Nelson Mandela.
This year's winner, according to the committee, displayed compassion, humor, and clear-eyed artistry in creating an intense, riveting document. The Truer Than Fiction Award goes to... Garrett Scott and Ian Olds for Occupation Dreamland.
I'm getting through this. I don't know how many of you know, but 2 days ago, my filmmaking partner, Garrett Scott, died of a heart attack and at age of 37. So I'm just trying to get through today and go from there. But I didn't want to come, but I came for him, to honor him, the work he does, the work we did together. He was someone that when I think of him, I think of his powerful and unique mind. I think of his sense of humor, and I think of his warm heart. We spent 2 months together in Iraq and had a sort of a heavy time over there, and we came back, and we were editing this film, and we still somehow we ended up laughing all the time while we were editing a war movie about Fallujah. So I don't know how that works, but that's a testament to him. One of the soldiers in the film called me last night and said, you know, we've been taught not to trust anybody with a camera or a microphone, and this was a guy that had politics far different than Garrett and myself. And he said, but I knew I could trust you guys and I could trust Garrett, and that would mean a lot to Garrett, and probably more than this award, in fact. He was an honest man, and who I am as a person and a filmmaker, I owe in great part to him. So I accept this award on his behalf and in his honor. I loved him like a brother. I miss him already.
The next grant, the IFC Acura Someone to Watch Award, is presented to a promising director. The finalists are...
Ian Gamazon, Neil De La Jana, directors of Cavite. Robinson DeVore, director of Police Beat. Jay Duplass, director of The Puffy Chair.
The selection committee cited the winner's dynamic use of imagination and the ability to tell nail-biting story economically and intelligently. The 2006 IFC's Acura Someone to Watch Award goes to... Ian Gamazon, Neil De La Jana, yeah! For Cavite.
$25,000. We just tripled our budget right there. Wanted to thank family, friends, everybody that supported us, obviously, throughout the film and the filmmaking process. Film Independence, the gang from the Los Angeles Film Festival for qualifying us for this award, our representation, Peter McHugh, and the gang from William Morris.
And also our co-producer, Quinton, the advanced producing class at UT, and last but not least, John and Janet Pearson for believing in us. Thank you.
Thank you.
The AMC American Express Award Producers Award honors a producer of independent films who has displayed a genuine gift for the indefinable art of producers. The finalists are...
Caroline Barron, producer of Capote and Monsoon Wedding. Graham Bergman, producer of Brick and Conversations with Other Women. Mike S. Ryan, producer of Junebug and Palindromes.
In selecting this year's recipient, the committee recognized this producer's skillful perseverance and accomplishment in selecting challenging and important projects. This year's AMC American Express Producers Award goes to... Caroline Barron for Capote and Monsoon Wedding.
I had to read this. I had a baby 10 days ago, and my memory's a little foggy. God, thank you to Film Independent, to American Express, AMC, for this amazing honor. We all know that making independent films is not easy, and I really salute my fellow nominees for their perseverance. I've also been at this for a while, so it's nice that I'm finally emerging. I wouldn't be standing here if I didn't have really, really talented friends. Mira Nair's creativity and spirit were the driving force behind Monsoon Wedding. And Bennett Miller's singular and uncompromising vision and strength made Capote such an incredible directorial debut. Bennett, you're amazing. And Danny Futterman's incredible first screenplay was that rare piece of material for a producer that we all dream of. And of course, Philip Seymour Hoffman's performance is like none other. And you all make me look so incredibly good, and I thank you for that and for your friendship and inspiration. And of course, we wouldn't make these films if we didn't have money to make them and distribution, and I thank UA for having the courage to make it, and Sony Classics for having the incredible elegance and amazing wherewithal to get it out there in the mainstream, and IFC for making Monsoon Wedding. And then I want to just say that 7 years ago, I founded a refugee relief organization called FilmAid that brings films to refugees and displaced around the world. And it's through that work that I finally understood why I do what I do and how what we do has so much power and value. And this award just is encouragement to keep doing that. And I want to thank my parents who are here and for their unbelievable support. My angel of a husband, Anthony, is my partner in everything that I do. And our two sons, Asher and Emmanuel. And Emmanuel, thank you for not waiting until today to arrive. Thank you very much.
One of my favorite actors, Lisa Kudrow, and Jeremy Piven.
Thanks.
What was
Jeremy and I are honored to present.
That was awkward, wasn't it? Because she clearly meant you, because she said Lisa Kudrow and Jeremy Piven. And
all right.
That was weird. Whatever. Well, I'm sorry. Let's do this.
No, I think she thinks. Probably because you play an agent so well. She thinks you're an agent. She doesn't even know you're an actor.
No, I mean, I made out with Sarah at her bat mitzvah. I've known her my whole life. So, remember that, Sarah? Yeah, thumbs up. I'm confused by tonight. It's just a very, today, where are we? I have a crush on the Olsen twins. I don't know which one to go for. Yeah. I don't think they mind. There's been 116 George Clooney jokes. I didn't get the feminine hygiene joke. Okay. I'm not in any of the movies.
Hey, you
I don't
hug it out, you little bitch?
I do.
All right.
You want to hug?
Not really, no.
Not really.
We should.
Okay.
Yeah.
That bit didn't work. We play through, though.
The nominees for Best Female Lead are... It was supposed to be you.
It was supposed to be you. Indeed, Felicity Huffman for Transamerica.
You consider yourself a happy person?
Yes.
Miss Osborne, there's no such thing as a right answer in this office.
Yes, I'm a very happy person.
How can I help you if you won't be honest with me?
You can sign that consent form, please.
The American Psychiatric Association categorizes gender dysphoria as a very serious mental disorder.
After my operation, not even a gynecologist will be able to detect anything out of the ordinary about my body. I will be a woman.
Dina Corzine, 40 Shades of Blue.
They want you to come in to same class, and I don't know, I feel very stupid because I know you will never do it.
I'll do it.
A lot of parents do it, you know.
It's not a big problem. I said I knew it.
Laura Linney for The Squid and the Whale.
I'm having a hard time.
Where were we during all this? Did you bring men home?
Not well, not. Not when your father was in town. You actually met Richard, both your boys. He came over for takeout once.
You disgust me. You weren't even a writer until recently. You just bailed on Dad because he's not as successful as he used to be and hasn't gotten the recognition he deserves.
You sound like your father.
No, I'm glad I sound like him. You disgust me.
You're being a shit, Walt!
Essa Paetha Merkerson, Lackawanna Blues.
But you know, then I come to realize that even though God took that one that was so special from me, he filled my life up with so many others. But most of all, most of all, he gave me you.
And Cindy Williams for The Room.
Why don't you come to bed?
I woke up in the middle of the night last night and realized how tired I've been. I'm scared. Because sometimes I think I'm gonna die tired.
Award goes to... Felicity Huffman for Transamerica.
Give me.
now crying at the Spirit Awards. I want to thank Duncan Tucker for his vision, for his perseverance, and for his dedication to the truth. I want to thank Kevin Zegers for his brilliance and for making a road trip in the 110-degree heat in Arizona in a station wagon with no air conditioning fun. I'd like to thank the brilliant Fionnuala Flanagan, Elizabeth Pena, and Graham Greene for their kindness, their excellence, and their advice. I want to thank Harvey and Bob Weinstein, who championed this film when no one else would, and IFC Films. I'm sure I'm forgetting someone. I'd like to thank my agent, Chris Andrews, who, in his insanity, has always believed in me. Go figure. In true independent fashion, it was about 1 o'clock in the morning, and a 10K lamp blew out and sprayed glass all over everyone. And when we went to the truck to try and get a new lamp, we found that the driver had gotten drunk and run off to Mexico with the keys, so we couldn't continue. And then the fourth caterer in a row quit, and so Duncan had to go to Denny's to try and get second meal for everyone. And then I looked up and I saw our key grip Bob on a 14-foot ladder with a flashlight in his mouth, trying to jerry-rig a light so we could continue shooting. And he was going, "This fucking movie better win some fucking awards, because it's a fucking pain in the ass." So I want you to get out your pens and paper, and his name is Bob Izzo, and he's the best and coolest key grip. And we kept shooting thanks to him, and I just want to say, Bob, we won the fucking award.
And now to serenade his good friends George Clooney and Grant Heslop, here is Richard Kind.
TV with his colleague known as Fred. One fine day they was working on a show that made him a target for Senator Joe McCarthy, that is, junior Republican from Wisconsin, chair of the Permanent Subcommittee on Investigations. Well, next thing you know, Ed's boss is on the phone, says, "Ed and Fred, guess we're in this all alone. For now, I'm behind you, but you better get it right, or I'm gonna have to tell you good night." Team put together lots of clips. McCarthy was felled by the statement from his lips, and Ed read a quote from the literature shelves. "The fault's not in our stars, but in ourselves." Shakespeare, that is, Julius Caesar, Act 1, Scene 2. "Your returneth now, you hear?" For you, buddy, for you. How proud am I to present? Good night and good luck.
The next show is going to be about Senator McCarthy. I'm going to go right at him.
This is no time for men who oppose Senator McCarthy's methods. Keep silent.
He's going to come after me.
You understand the position you're putting us in?
Let's walk very carefully through these next few moments.
Why don't you just fire me?
Mr. Edward R. Murrow has made repeated attacks upon me and those fighting communists.
We cannot defend freedom abroad by deserting it at home. Good night, and good luck.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the award for Best Cinematography, please welcome Jennifer Jason Leigh, and from Jelly Smoke, Michael Ealy.
Without cinematographers, films would be plays.
That's it?
That's it.
Okay. Excellent point. The nominees for Best Cinematographer are
Robert Elswit, good night and good luck. John Foster, Keen.
I was with my daughter. She was abducted downstairs on the lower level.
William Keen.
Adam Kimmel, Capote. Chris Mengis, The Three Burials of Melquiades Estrada. Harris Savitas, Last Days.
And the award goes to Robert Elswit, good night and good luck.
This is the only craft award that's given out at the Independent Spirits, and it really does acknowledge the work of so many other people, the production designer, the art director, the editor, the costumer. In the case of Goodnight and Good Luck, it's Jim Bissell, it's Jan Pascal, it's Steve Marioni, it's Louise Frogley. This really honors their work, as it does for all the other nominees, all the other categories, all the other films who had great production designers, great art directors. But all of us on Good Night and Good Luck know that no one would have really looked at our work this way had this film not been so beautifully directed. Thank you, George. Thank you, Helen.
Don't go to the bathroom. It's time for the John Cassavetes Award. Here to present it, our Best Female Lead nominee, Laura Linney and Peter Sarsgaard.
Hey, y'all. It's kind of... It's lots of good stuff back then. We're giving out the John Cassavetes Award. I thought it'd only be right. The John Cassavetes Award is given every year to a director, writer, and producer who carry on in the spirit of the guy who made movies in his own home, John Cassavetes. And by making an exceptional feature film for less than $500,000, in some cases a lot less.
The nominated films this year include dramas, a comedy of sorts, a suspense film, and an indefinable furniture-related project, each one made by an imaginative team that regarded limited resources as a challenge, not as an obstacle. The nominees are Brick.
Slow down. This is good.
No.
You better be sure you want to know what you want. No.
Keep up with me now. I see that you're trying to help her. And I don't know anybody who would do that for me.
Now you are dangerous. I set out to know, put her on the spot. And put her in front of the gun.
Conventioners.
I was just trying to get in touch with her. I'm in New York, and I wanted to see if she was around.
You know, I had a huge crush on you.
Really?
Would you ever date one of these girls?
Yeah, crazy.
So, what are you doing in New York?
I'm here for the Republican convention.
Wow. Can I buy you a drink?
Would things be different if I were Democrat?
I don't know.
Jacob, what's your name?
Cindy.
Say something to make her laugh. Tell her she has a beautiful forehead.
Be honest with her. Let her know your situation. Are you still taking your meds?
What?
Do you know the story of Lazarus? Do you know the story of Lazarus? If I killed you, do you believe I could bring you back to life?
The puffy chair.
Remember the puffy chair when we were little?
Yeah.
I found a replica of it on eBay. Emily and I are driving in the van to pick it up.
God, do you even want to be in this relationship? What the chances are that we might actually get married?
This van is contaminated, and I know what it is. It's this goddamn chair.
If you asked me to marry you right now, I would say yes. And I want that.
Room.
Thank you, sir.
More than 700 Iraqi police.
Look at those eyes! She says no!
And the Independent Spirit Award goes to...
Conventioneers.
Strategy of not getting nervous by not preparing a speech has backfired. But thank you so much, Film Independent. Don Hudson, Film Independent has been incredibly supportive of us. Joel and I both went through the labs, and you know, making independent films is pretty fucking hard. And it's great to have a place where you know. You can find a community and help me out here.
I'd like to thank MasterCard for not cutting us off while we were making the film. I'd like to thank all the people who worked on the film. I'd like thank all of our amazing actors and our crew and NYU for helping us out with it. And my parents, her parents, our siblings, my siblings. You don't have siblings.
The film sort of started with, okay, like, Republican National Convention in New York, let's go make some mischief. And it had this crazy idea of a love story set against this setting. And from there, just all these amazing people came along with us on this ride. The actors, you know, putting up with acting in the middle of 500,000 people in the protests. And Matt Mabe, Woodwind Coons, Alec Friedman, Andreas Burgess, all the great people who worked on the film.
And everybody vote in November 2006, please.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
He's a singer who acts and an actor who sings. He's the most entertaining type of individual imaginable. From the three burials of Melquiades Estrada, this is Dwight Yoakam.
Well, they're gonna cover up the murder. They know who shot my friend but won't tell me. I'm duty bound to figure out who killed that herder. And all I gotta do is act drastically. Seems the killer's a young border patrol man who shuns his wife and reads pornography. I'll make him dig up my pal from his hole, man. And all I gotta do is act drastically. Well, I'll force him to join me on a mission, escorting the cadaver on the horse. We're all gonna smell decomposition. And on that ride, he'll lose his lunch, of course. Well, I hope we find that Mexican pueblito where my poor friend can spend eternity. I'll let my captive go and say finito. And all I gotta do is act drastically. And now here's the three burials of Melquiades Estrada.
Ando trabajo.
¿Qué clase de trabajo?
Soy vaquero.
What line of work bring you to Texas?
Border Patrol.
Now see some photo ID, sir.
I need to talk to you.
What about?
Gomez told him who killed that Mexican.
You gotta arrest him.
I can't do that. Are you crazy?
No, I'm not.
You killed him, now dig him up.
Ah! You try to run away again, I'll kill you. I guess you know that by now.
He was a good friend of mine.
Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together and pray for the director of Clerks 2, Kevin Smith.
I know we're here to honor, you know, all the nominees and whatnot, but I personally want to give a big shout out for the host, for Sarah Silverman. Because finally, there's an award show host that you'd want to fuck. Kind of like Jon Stewart, too, you know? I can see myself getting all like Heath Ledger on him. You know, that kind of thing. I want to take it to a sensitive place right now. Kind of like I'd like to with Jon Stewart. I haven't been here in 8 years on this stage at the Indie Spirit Awards. The last time I was here was a first date for me and a woman who wound up becoming my wife. I was nominated for screenplay for Chasing Amy, and I won. And no. And I was fishing a little bit. And I won, and then that was really cool. But the best part about that night is that is the night that we fell in love. Me and Jen fell in love. And so it's kind of nice to be back here to celebrate that anniversary. And when I say we fell in love, I mean we totally fucked. For a long time, which is rare for me. And so I guess what I'm saying to all you winners tonight is like you take home that trophy. You probably have a good shot at fucking my wife. And all I ask is that I can watch. Preferably from under a glass table. I've been directing for about 12 years now, and this is the year that I finally learned what directing's all about, really, and the commitment that it takes to be a director. Apparently, to be a director, you gotta be willing to put on a dress, go out and solicit blowjobs in Hollywood. Which I'll be doing right after the show based on that reaction. But I'm going to introduce, believe me, the irony is not lost on me presenting Best Director, me being the worst director, but I'm going to introduce you to a bunch of nominees who are really, really great cats. Nominees for Best Director are, for Brokeback Mountain, Ang Lee. For Good Night and Good Luck, George Clooney. For Mysterious Skin, Greg Araki. For Nine Lives, Rodrigo Garcia. And for the squid and the whale, Noah Baumbach. I realize I probably just shot myself in the foot for getting laid tonight. So one of these cats is definitely getting lucky. The winner, Ang Lee for Brokeback Mountain.
A director. I'm just a serious director. I'm all tired and everything. But thank you. It's been 5 years since last time I stood here. In between Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon and Brokeback Mountain, I made the Hulk. But in my mind, I've never left independent spirit. For as long as I'm allowed to make movies, I'd like to think that I make them with independent spirit. To me, it means, I don't know about to you, to me, it means to grab as much money as you can to do what you're not really supposed to do. That's what it means to me. Of course, we cannot totally be independent when we make movies. I rely on the brilliant story by Annie Proulx. The brilliant script by Diana Ossana, Larry McMurtry, and their consultant. The love and support from from Focus Features, everyone there, especially Jim Shemus, David Lindy. Thank you for your love and support. And Bill Pollard and everyone in cast and crew, they're just brilliant. I want to thank them from the bottom of my heart. And in the year, the Oscar might as well be the independent spirit. I really treasure this encouragement. Thank you so much.
Oh my God, I know the perfect guy for you too. His name is Arthur Fonzarelli. He loves twins. If not him, Jeremy Piven, kind of a Jewish Fonzie. Ang Lee looks exactly like my boyfriend when my boyfriend smiles really big. I fell in love with him in Breaking Away, and I'm so gay for her that it makes me harden. They're not all gems. From the upcoming movie, American Dreams, Marcia Gay Harden and Dennis Quaid.
The category of best male lead is an exceptionally strong one this year, and because of that, the idea that one of these nominees is the best seems ludicrous.
So before we announce the outcome of this impossible choice, we want to salute a group of actors that really are just having one of the finest performances of their careers so far.
Please join us in applauding all these astonishing actors. Their names are Philip Seymour Hoffman, Capote.
There is one singular reason I keep coming here.
Truman.
November 14th, 1959. 3 years ago. 3 years. And that's all I want to hear from you.
I asked you not to, ever.
This is absurd. Do you know what absurd means?
Terrence Howard, Hustle and Flow.
Yeah, your girl Keisha, man. One day she gonna dream big, the way kids do, you know. And she gonna come to me and ask me, when she grow up, can she become president? Now, I know that little girl got a hoe for a mama and a trick for a daddy that nobody even know where he at. But I tell you something, I'm gonna look her right in the eye, and I'm gonna lie. Because sometimes that's what you gotta do.
Heath Ledger, Brokeback Mountain.
Are you shut up about it? It's Aaron's fault. The bottom line is, we're around each other, and this thing grabs hold of us again in the wrong place, in the wrong time, and we're dead.
David Strathairn, good night and good luck.
The actions of the junior senator from Wisconsin have caused alarm and dismay amongst our allies abroad and given considerable comfort to our enemies. And whose fault is that? Not really his. He didn't create this situation of fear. He merely exploited it, and rather successfully. Cassius was right. The fault, dear Brutus, is not in our stars, but in ourselves. Good night, and good luck.
And Jeff Daniels, The Squid and the Whale.
He called me right after. He said, Bernie, I think you can save your marriage. I told him I didn't think there was anything else I could do. I did try everything.
And the Spirit Award goes to Philip Seymour Hoffman, Capote.
Wow, it's a big room. Wow, thank you. Thank you. I'm glad you said it. It's ludicrous. I've been wanting to say that for a while now. It's ludicrous, and I've been given enough. I've been given enough, and I want to share this. I want to share this so badly, I can't tell you. And with all the nominees, I can't tell you how fantastic these gentlemen are. Not only as actors, not only as actors, but as men, and I mean that. I've been hanging out with you guys for the past 2 months, and you're just fantastic. I've been having such a great time with you. You know, it's the only thing that I don't want to end. You know, and I just wanted to say that I think the Independent Spirit Awards. To me, is about making a film where there's no place to hide. And that might sound kind of extreme, but I do feel like if you're on a film and you feel like there's no place to hide, then maybe you're in the right place. And what I mean by that is that there's no comfort. There's only the work. You walk out of your trailer or your room or wherever hallway you're in, and you're like, oh my God, I gotta work, because everyone around me basically is encircling me and just looking at me and saying the work must be done, and done now and done well, because our lives depend on it somehow. And those people are Bennett Miller, the director, and Danny Futterman, the writer. And if we can all for a moment go back to the time when we were making these films and remember what that felt like, you know what I mean. And the cast, the wonderful cast in this film, and the support from Caroline Barron, and the support from Bill Vince from Infinity, and the support from Danny Rosette. It was a real cumulative effort, and thank you very much. And Michael and Tom, you know, I feel, Mimi, I love you, and thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present our final award, please join me in welcoming the star of The Painted Veil and the honorary chairperson of the Independent Spirit Awards, Naomi Watts.
Every year at these awards, we struggle to come up with a definition for independent film. And every year, the definition becomes more tortured and stretched. In the end, we usually fall back on something that sounds a lot like the Supreme Court's definition of pornography. You know it when you see it. But the truth is that there is a definition of independent film, and it's right under our noses. It's not a budget limit, or a degree of major studio involvement, or the size of the release. It's the films themselves. When you see a film that is authentic, that is daring, that is different, that is deeply true, no matter how fantastic the plot, when you see these things, you know you're watching an independent film. So if anyone asks you what exactly is an independent film, this is the answer. The nominees for Best Feature are Brokeback Mountain, Diana Ossana, James Seamus. Capote, Caroline Byrne, William Vince, and Michael O'Hoven. Good Night, Good Luck, Grant Heslov. The Squid and the Whale, Wes Anderson, Peter Newman, Charles Gawin, Clara Markowitz. And the Three Burials of Melquiades Estrada. Michael Fitzgerald, Tommy Lee Jones, Luc Besson, Pierre-Yves Le Pogam. Sorry. And the Spirit Award goes to Brokeback Mountain, Diana Ossana, James Seamus.
Crap.
Thank you, Film Independent.
Yes. And Brokeback Mountain is about independence.
And that's why we want to thank General Electric.
Let's see. What did you say? Which owns NBC?
Which owns Universal?
Which owns Focus Features?
Which owns Del Mar Productions?
And am I next?
They rented us. They just rented us, and we're so glad they did.
Yeah, but you know, Brokeback is about really hot guys.
And so we have to thank Bill Pollard and Michael Costigan and Larry McMurtry and David Lindy and Mike Hausman for all the hot man-on-man action on this film.
But Brokeback is also about work.
And we want to thank the hardworking Annie Prue and the amazing team at Focus Features and our incredible cast and crew and the unions that protect them.
But mostly, Brokeback is about sheep.
So we want to thank our shepherd, Ang Lee. Thank you, Ang.
Thank you, Ang.